Good morning, everyone. My name is Father Ralph Argentino. I am a retired priest from the Diocese of St. Petersburg, and I just moved July 1st to my home in Ocoee, so it's not too far from here, about 25 minutes. I'm originally born and raised in Brooklyn, New York. Anyone from Brooklyn out there? Three people, what a shame, look at that. And I'm also Italian. Anyone Italian out there? Dante, the great Italian poet, once said, "God understands all languages, but the angels speak to God in Italian." The first reading in the Gospel deal about people who live in luxury, eat fabulous meals every day, live in lovely homes, and they only care about themselves. In the gospel, the rich man was very rich. He wore purple clothes, linen underwear. He ate meat. People in those days ate meat maybe once every other week. He feasted every day. Now, he wasn't mean to Lazarus. He wasn't abusive to Lazarus. But he never realized that he was at his door, totally oblivious of this poor beggar covered with sores laying at his gate. And Lazarus only wanted crumbs from the table. Now, in those days, they didn't have forks or knives or spoons. They ate with their hands. And the rich would clean their hands with crumbs of the bread, the husks of the bread, and throw the bread on the floor. That is what Lazarus wanted, some of that discarded bread. Well, you know the story. The beggar dies, goes to heaven in the bosom of Abraham, and the rich man winds in that place that is a little hot. Now remember, when you read some of these gospel stories, they love to exaggerate to get across the point. Jesus was a great storyteller. Hell is not fire, fire. Of course, whoever's in hell, that's your soul. Soul is spiritual. Physical fire can't harm the soul. But it's the separation from God that is painful. Nevertheless, so this poor rich guy is in hell. He sees Abraham having a great time, and Lazarus having a great time in the bosom of Abraham, and he says, "Oh, let him dip his finger in water, Lazarus, to quench my thirst." And Abraham says, "Nah, too late. You made the wrong choice. You have to pay for your choices that you made. All right, send Lazarus to my brothers. I have five brothers. Let them be warned." Again, no. They have the prophets. They have the scriptures. That should be enough. Notice, ladies, the rich man says, "Warn my five brothers." What about the ladies of his household? Did he have sisters? What happened to them? Now, in those days, the order of importance was the sons, the property, the cattle, and the wife. That's how it was. In any case, what's the moral of the story? It's simply this. You and I have many Lazarists that pass our life. How do we treat them? I don't know any of you personally. Maybe I know Brad a little bit, but that's about it. If your concept of God is a universal bellboy, "Lord, give me that, Lord, take that away," that's not God. I pray every day, "Lord, make me thin." That wasn't a joke. But if I don't watch, you know, not too much pasta, if I don't eat, you know, gotta cut the raviolis down, God will be with us in good times and in bad. He will give us the strength to endure and to overcome whatever might come. So those prayers of asking for things, those are baby prayers, and they're okay. But Paul says, put on the mind of Christ, that putting on his mind, you will change your heart, and changing your hearts, you will change your behavior. That's where it's at. How do you behave to one another? You know, interesting, I was, can I come down here? Could you see me? Yes, Father. Are you pregnant? Your first one? Your third one. Good luck for you. Wednesday she's going to have the baby? I have a family in Oyster Bay, New York, where I was. I'm not suggesting this. They had 10 boys, one girl, and two boys after that. No, that's too much. Good luck. Anyway, I was thinking of what I was going to say today, and it was a Saturday, and I stopped at a red light, and I looked, and there was a poor lady begging. I'm hungry. I have no food. I pushed down my window. I only had a couple of bucks. I gave her $5. She said, oh, thank you very much. You thought I gave her $1,000. When you meet anybody, how do you treat them? Family, friends. Are you loving, kind, gracious, or are you sourpussed, stingy, mean, fresh, and rude? You have to ask yourselves that question. How much are we like Jesus? The way to heaven is always a rough road. Charity covers a multitude of sins. Go find someone sick in soul, sick in body, sick in mind, and do something. Something. And God will bless you. Nietzsche once said, the German philosopher, he said a few interesting things. He went stark raving mad at the age of 45. Nietzsche said this, if you Christians believe you have been redeemed, how come the whole lot of you look so unredeemed? Good question. When they see you, do they see a loving, kind Jesus? There's one line in the gospel asked by John the Baptist to Jesus when he was in prison. Are you the one who is to come, or must we look for another? Let them never say that about us. We are the ones who have been sent. Be the light of Christ, the warmth of Christ to all you meet. You got it? Yes, Father. Oy vey. When I was in my diocese, I was the director of the diaconate for 13 years and director of Catholic cemeteries. That second ministry was fabulous. No one complained. I've been ordained 48 years now, and I was ordained by Bishop Fulton J. Sheen. Yes. He was tiny, you know, about 5'6", 5'7", wasn't very tall. In any case, when I go to bed, I say my night prayers, and I say one prayer in particular. I've been saying it for 48 years now, that keeps me kind of centered, and hopefully I will also die a happy priest. And the prayer goes like this. Oh God, I give you thanks. I have no wife, I have no kids, I have no debts, I have no mother-in-law, amen. Mother-in-laws, it's just a joke. So we like to now dismiss those who are studying through the RCIA. We ask them to come forward to study God's word.